I don't want your videos to get washed away, just like everyone else's, in the sea of social content. It's frustrating to spend a ton of time and effort prepping and filming and editing your videos, then you've got to figure out how to put it on social in a way that stands out and gets attention. Am I right? We just want our videos to work. We want people to see our videos and like it, literally and figuratively. Knowing and understanding these options is going to make you successful. We know that maximum file size is 4 gigs, which is not very big. We know that over 80% of all Facebook users will use Facebook on a mobile device only. And we know we have 3 main options for the dimensions of our Facebook video. But how we set up and film has a big impact on those dimensions that we want to use. The traditional landscape, or 16:9, looks great in YouTube, but put those same dimensions in Facebook and it doesn't really stand out. If you shoot in 16:9 and post a video in a 4:5 or maybe a 1:1 ratio, that typically makes it look a little zoomed in, like a close-up that didn't need to happen. And flipping your camera around to a 9:16 ratio instead of a 16:9 ratio sounds like a good idea, until you realize once it's in Facebook, it compresses to a 4:5 ratio and it never looks as good. We solve for all of these issues by filming slightly more zoomed out than we normally would, whether that's in the zoom or maybe backing up slightly. That way, we give ourselves a bit more room to work with when we pop this thing into Premiere Pro for editing. All we need to do is come down here to New Item, Sequence, go ahead and choose our digital SLR, 1080p, that's what I like, 24 frames per second. Let me show you a couple settings here that'll make the biggest impact. Traditionally, it's 1920 by 1080. That creates our 16:9. If we want to use a 4:5 ratio, we want to change this to 1080 by 1350. And of course, if we want a 1:1, then it's 1080 by 1080. Make sure to save these settings as a template. Just one less thing to worry about. For now, I think I'm going to stick with the 1080 by 1350 and create a 4:5 ratio video. Drop that guy right in there. And because obviously I'm filming at 16:9, but I'm dropping it into a 4:5, there's a mismatch. We do want to keep the existing settings. And then all we need to do is play with the scale a little bit, and voila. And if you want to go that extra mile, you can add some auto-generated captions. Then all we have to do is dial in our expert settings, keeping in mind the limitations of Facebook in this case. I like to start with the basic Facebook export and then go from there. For maximum quality, we're gonna have to balance out the file size limits with our bitrate. For simplicity's sake, let's just say that the higher the bitrate, the higher the quality, but also higher the file size. Yes, there are other things that play a factor in here, but let's just keep it simple for now. I prefer a VPR one pass with a 15 bitrate, but you can see if I was to double this bitrate, look what it does to my estimated file size here. Facebook is still going to compress the video quality, but I feel like this gives me the best bang for my buck. If you are gonna include captions, make sure you flip over to this captions tab and either select sidecar file if you plan on uploading, or burn those captions into the video. Now that you have some real options, hopefully some real confidence, go experiment. Then write about your results in the comments below.